Hi everyone, and welcome back to Curious by Nature. My name is Elena, and today we're joined by some extra special guests from Wings and Talons. Wings and Talons is a nonprofit, all-volunteer organization dedicated to caring for non-releasable birds of prey, also called raptors. And we're super excited to be able to learn from them. I'm curious, what makes a bird of prey a bird of prey, and what makes these birds so unique? What clues can we use to tell if a bird is a raptor? So let's ask the pros to find out more. Hi Kay, I'm so excited that you're here with us today, and I'm super excited to ask you some questions about our great horned owl here.
Yeah.
The first thing I've noticed are how big her eyes are. Is that common for all birds of prey, or is that unique to this owl?
Birds of prey do need to have really big eyes so that they can see their prey from great distances and great heights. So it is a really important part of their survival, really. And they actually have 8 times the rods and cones that we do as humans, so it allows them to see in different color ranges and different lights and things like that. Some birds can see in the ultraviolet range, like kestrels. They can track their prey through the urine trail that the animal leaves, and there's ultraviolet light in that. If birds could read, they could read a book across the length of a football field. So that's how incredibly extraordinary their eyesight is.
Oh, that's amazing.
Yeah, and if we had eyes, they take up a third of the size of the skull.
Okay.
So if we had eyes as big as a raptor, we would have eyes the size of grapefruits.
Wow.
Which would be a little bit weird, right?
It would be, that's huge.
Yeah.
The next really cool thing I've noticed is this curved beak. Is that another unique thing for a bird of prey?
It is. It's something that raptors need to be able to catch their prey and subdue it, and then eventually to eat it and to rip off all of the feathers and the fur and things that they need to get to the flesh. The beaks of all birds are pretty specific to their diet. So for example, a songbird is going to have a small rectangular beak to eat seeds and berries and small insects. And think of hummingbirds with their long beaks to get nectar. Birds like herons and cranes and different birds, water birds, they need a very sharp beak to be able to spear the fish with. So yes, the raptors do need that curved beak to be able to catch their prey and to eat it efficiently.
Amazing. It looks very sharp, and so do the talons. Are the talons very sharp? And
extremely sharp.
Extremely sharp. Do all birds have talons, or is this another unique thing for a bird of prey?
Well, talons are unique to birds of prey. You know, all animals do have nails, and our nails are made of the same substance. It's called keratin. The raptors have a raptor bone that's enclosed with this keratin sheath, and it's very strong and allows them to grab their prey and subdue it and be able to eat it. Owls can ratchet their grip, and you know, it's like hundreds of pounds per square inch.
Wow.
So it's a very, very strong grip, but it's also very humane because the prey doesn't have to suffer. You know, they can just quickly get it over with and have their meal.
Wow, thank you.
Yeah.
The last question I wanted to ask is about their feathers. The feathers, they're beautiful. Do they have any special adaptations that help with hunting?
Well, their feathers are, of course, critically important. Our great horned owl here, as all birds do, have flight feathers in their wings and tails that allow them to fly efficiently. They also have what are contour feathers that cover most of their body and give them their shape. And then they have that insulating layer, that down wispy layer that some of our coats are made of, that allows them to kind of puff out and have those insulators against the weather, whether it be heat or cold. They do molt every year, so they do lose their feathers and then grow new ones. And they also have a gland at the base of their tail, an oil gland, that they can access to then preen their feathers and make them waterproof and protect them against nature.
Wow, very cool. Thank you so much for joining us today. I really enjoyed
this. Of course. Wings and Talons is a nonprofit organization. We're entirely volunteer run. We have 12 ambassador birds at our facility at Springbrook Nature Center. And we use the birds to attend different programs to educate the public about these birds of prey so that we can all live harmoniously together.
That's our show for today. We're so happy we could highlight our friends from Wings and Talons. I've seen some raptors in my neighborhood in Chicago, and I'm so glad I was able to learn more about them. If you have any questions for Wings and Talons, be sure to drop them in the comments. From time to time, we bring the birds to the Nature Museum for live programming. To find out when these programs are happening, go to our website or join our email list at the link in the description. If you liked today's episode, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel so you never miss a video. If you'd like to learn more about birds, we've picked out some more Curious by Nature episodes for you here. We'll hope to see you swoop into the Nature Museum soon, and we'll see you back here next time on Curious by Nature.